If you would you turn with me, amen, to the book of Revelations, 21st chapter. And we'll read just the fourth verse. And we have a peace standing with you as we, amen, render God's word. Revelations 21.
Correct, made him feel bad.
where they wanted to be intimidated against me. Help me, Jesus. Have y'all done anybody doing something like that before? Amen. I said some things that just went right to people. And she got mad at me. She said, "You stay with me, I'm gonna do something to you." Mental pain. We went to a mental site and she paid me. Amen.
Amen.
Brother, you did this, I don't care. And he hated me. Caused mental pain. Amen. If anybody know what I'm talking about, just go ahead and say amen. Let me die.
Hallelujah.
And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in the truth that he is, hallelujah, who he is. Why do you say that? Because when Adam was there, y'all remember, laying there on the ground where God had orchestrated and constructed man, and he was laying there out of the, made from the very dust of the earth, he wasn't nothing but dead flesh. Yeah. But God stepped aside and breathed into him. Mm-hmm. He breathed life into him. And his spirit was of God. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. We do need a painkiller. Yes. And people go through situations in life, amen, where they take a BC. I gotta have me a BC every day. The doctor said, yeah, I want you to take a BC because I want your heart to keep, you know, flowing straight. The BC is supposed to be a pain and aspirin. Mm-hmm. Some people take bare aspirin. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. For their pain. Some people take what Anderson, Excedrin. Uh-oh. Vicodin. Uh-huh. Right. And when you do too much of that, you don't feel no pain. You be trying to get some Vicodin every day. Amen. Hey, bro, can I get that bottle? I know you can get one from the doctor over there. You know, I can give you $20 for it, you know? Give me just one of them Vicodin. Kill all my pain. That's my pain killer. Oh, no, I ain't got no injury. I don't have any wounds or anything. I just need to kill the pain. What pain? I don't know, but I need Vicodin. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And there's some other stuff that's more strong than Vicodin. Listen, I'm in the military and they give me some pain pills. I take one pain pill and I'm dead all week long. There's one that I'm going to get a little yellow strip on. I can't even pronounce the name of it. They send me all kinds of nasty. I said, look, I can't get in the middle with all this pill. Pain free. Amen. The physical aspect of pain. But the mental and the spiritual, listen to this. He said, faith is a substance of things hoped for. Stay with me now. And the evidence of things not seen. Now I'm going through some things in my life.
Come on.
And it brought mental stress. And the first thing the physical doctor told me to do was to go see another doctor and lay on his couch and tell his doctor all about my pain. Mm-hmm. And when I get finished telling that doctor about all my pain up here, they're going to give me a bill, which is going to cause me more pain. Amen. $200 bill for talking to you for half an hour. And I ain't got nothing done. But if I got faith in God, amen. Lord, I got a problem today. I've been trying to shake this thing in my mind, God. But I just can't shake it. Lord, can you touch my mind? He said, he that the mind stays upon the Lord. If I can just keep you in my mind, God. You'll take that pain from me. And because I trust you. Give me a chance here. He's silent of a host. And if I trust you, God, I won't have to pay that $200 bill. Amen. Because I believe that you're going to deliver me from this mental, amen, stress and anguish, oh God. But as far as the physical side of pain, the pain can overwhelm us, and it can turn from physical and spiritual. Mental and spiritual. Physical, mental, and spiritual. It can override. Hallelujah. I'm not trying to badmouth the pharmaceutical companies. But listen, I don't know if this is me. I got, maybe I'm the don't see in this. But say I watch TV, and they have a commercial or advertisement for your sinus, stuff on your back, stuff on your joints. Amen. These commercials. They said you take this medicine, you get rid of this pain, and you take this, you get rid of this back pain. Now I've got some stuff on your eye don't feel bad no more. But then they turn around right here in the commercial. And they said, well, this might be suicidal medicine. This medicine might make you swell up. This medicine can give you a heart attack. And you got more pain in your medicine than it's going to get to you. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Go on, buy all this pain. The side of the lateral damage. I'm taking a pain pill for a headache and my leg done swelled up. And what makes a man, they tell it to you before you take it. That's crazy. What makes it even worse, they will charge you $89 for 15 meals. Hallelujah. God is good. Excuse me. Hallelujah. But the man, you know, we get angry looking at it though. With these commercials sometimes they're just like, wow, if it takes all that, I'd just rather go through the pain that I'm going through. You know, just amen. A painkiller, I need a real painkiller. Hallelujah. I looked at this and I was like, what happened about 2 months ago? Not yesterday, but 2 months ago. There's a lady with two children. And a tornado was coming through. And so she elected to cover her children. Amen. So the tornado would not bring pain to her children. And what happened was, I think she lost both of her feet. One got cut off at the... And I believe that she said in the hospital that she prayed. Amen. That no harm and danger would come to her children. Somewhere there was emotional acceptance. God, help me. Help me through this pain, Lord. Because it's all around me. The physical aspect now I'm going through, the emotional, it's everywhere. It's all around me. And it seems that I can't get away from this pain. We all deal with some kind of pain today. Amen. Whether it be emotional or physical. Amen. On the job, they always messing with us. I can't get enough. It's pain. I can't make enough money to make my ends meet. It's pain. I can't deal with this rainbow. It's pain to bring me. Amen. That's what happens to me. And I'm saying, Lord, I need a painkiller. What can take away all this pain? Hallelujah. And the third part of it is that when we go through these things and we ask different entities to help us be relieved of this pain, we don't get the right answer until we call on Jesus. I don't know about you, but I remember when I was young, and I had a son called, his name was Joshua. And Joshua was going through so much pain in his life. He had three open heart surgeries. And I remember the last time I saw him, he came around the corner and he looked up at me. I'm a young man then. But I saw the expression on his face. And he was saying to me, Dad, I'm tired. And he would kneel down on the carpet and just lay there for a minute so he can regroup. But I remember when he was born. He was born at what they call a blue baby. And I remember at McDonald's house, amen, in Norfolk, me and my wife was there, and we began to pray. We began to render praises and pray to God, and God, keep our son, Lord.
for my pain that I didn't want to receive. After 22 months, Joshua died. And the Lord showed me. I allowed him to live because of your pain. I wanted to take him a long time ago. But because of your pain, I heard your cry. Amen. Just like I told y'all before, a mama bear out in the woods. 1,500 bears out there. And the baby bear cries out. That mama knows that voice of that child. Yeah. Amen. Amen. She knows the voice of a child. God knows the voice of us.
Yes.
Amen. And you cannot tell me that when Trayvon's mother said, I heard my son cry out to me.
Yes.
That's my son calling me.
Yes.
I know his voice.
Yes.
The pain that she endured.
Jesus.
Amen.
Yes.
The pain that she had to take off when she heard her son, Mama, help me.
Yes.
Say a little Hosha. But through his pain,
yes,
there was collateral damage.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Through him dying, there was collateral. What are you talking about?
Mm, come on, come on, come on.
The investigation went flip-flop. You don't dismiss it that fast. And then it bled on to the city.
Mm.
Collateral damage of pain. And once it bled on to the city, it went to the state. And to the country, and everybody around the world hearing about that case now.
Yeah.
Collateral damage of the pain. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Even yesterday, there was 120 tornadoes that set down. For as I know, 5 died. The pain, the physical pain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now listen to this. And it just baffles me. Because the Bible says this. In the end times, they will call good evil and evil good. Today they put on the TV that Mr. Zimmerman, who killed Trayvon, that's what I'm saying, this is me. Amen. They took some 1,200 skills. You know, the wig, bad skills, nice teeth. 1,200 skills in an art gallery in Denver, Colorado, and made a picture of Zimmerman. And they called it art. Out of somebody's pain. You hear it on the news. Now they're getting all kinds of hits from it and everything else. Hallelujah. Let me close here. The pain that we bring on ourselves can be rectified. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. Yes, we were born into sin. Yes, pain deals with us in our flesh. Because we're in a flesh of life. Yes, we have to deal with pain. But sometimes we induce the pain.
Yes, yes.
Amen. I had a lady yesterday come to me and say, well, don't bring me no bills. It's like,
come on.
The pastor just said, about me being your bills as a mailman. Why have to keep what they give me? Because I get paid. Amen. But she said, mailman, don't bring me no bills. I said, well, you created them. They yours. I didn't create the bill. You did. I just give it to you. What am I saying? So if you induce the pain, it's yours.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
I mean, when I was young, I was doing some stuff, and it was a sin, and it brought pain into my life.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Going out at night, doing things I shouldn't, it brought pain into my life. Mm-hmm. Sometimes pain comes to you and you haven't done anything. Tell me amen.
Amen.
But pain is going to be here. Hallelujah. There was a woman, thank you Jesus, sitting by the well, knowing that she has done 5 things wrong. Hallelujah. And I can see her saying, I'm not going through no physical pain right now.
and I see you on the cross. I bid you to come down, my son. But Jesus said, not so. I can see spirits saying, why? Jesus said, I've been there. Do you remember when I went to the garden? Nobody prayed with me. But I loved you so much that blood even came out of my forehead. I sweated blood. I was trying to kill the pain then. Then I asked my father, is there any way I can do this? Is there another way for a wrong that I can be the pain to what I'm going through?
Come on,
what I got to go through.
Yes, sir.
But my father told me that you must, matter of fact, I'm going to spit on you. I'm going to turn my back on you. That you're able to receive this pain. Oh, God. One thing we do, we hold our pain. Men have vision like this, and women have vision like this. Men will hold their pain. Alright, men, I'm talking to you, man. Men will hold things that hurt them. Help me, Jesus. They'll keep it concealed. And they won't even tell a lie because they have this pride, this ego to say, I'm hurt, but I don't want you to know I'm hurt. That's what men would do. That's why, men, we've got to get together in this church. We have to get together as men.
Amen.
And praise to God. And learn of God. And study of God. Because I know about pride. Amen. I know about ego.
Amen.
But the women, they'll let you have it. They'll let you know how they feel. As real God, we need to be suffocated. I'm sorry. Hallelujah. But isn't it wonderful that what we're going through, what we will go through, that we're able to take this pain, physical, mental, spiritual pain. And Jesus said, it's a burden to you. It's a burden. It's holding you down. It's holding you back. It won't let you pray. It won't let you study the word. It won't let you fellowship, not just on Sunday, but on prayer night. It won't let you do it. But Jesus said this. Take your pain and cast it. He said, literally, cast, throw at me. Throw your pain to me. Because that's what I did. There was a road that I had to walk. And I carried this old dogwood tree. But on that tree was man's pain. All the pain of man before us, man, all humanity, he carried that pain. Then he took it upon himself. He said, listen, you can snatch my beard out. You can put a crown and a thorn on my head, and I will bleed for you. I will bleed because of your pain. I put my life on the cross today because of your pain. Amen. There's somebody here today that's carrying this pain. Say it a whole shot. That will release the pain. Your pride, your ego will say, I'm not going to hold
the same interest. It doesn't have to be right now. In your secret closet. Hallelujah. You say, Lord, I surrender. I surrender my pain. I give my pain to you, Father, so I can be loosed, so I can have freedom to walk in your spirit, God, to do the things you commanded me to do. Take my pain, Father, and I'll be ever grateful. Hallelujah. Is there anyone today who has some kind of pain? Hallelujah. Raise your hand if you have some kind of pain. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Don't be ashamed. The devil's a liar. He's the accuser of the brother. Don't be ashamed. God is in this place. Hallelujah. And this pain, physical pain, and this mental pain, and there's spiritual pain. Stand on your feet. Let's give it to Jesus. Stand on your feet. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus, we are your people. We're your children. All the issues that we have, God, we know that you know them already. You just want us to acknowledge you, Father. And as we stand, God, we acknowledge, oh God, that you're able, God, to take every pain, God, every situation, God, and make it right, Father. We give you the glory for it, God.
Yes, God.
And we praise you for it now, God. Now, God, a fresh anointing, Lord, among your people, God.
Yes.
And we will forever, God, give you thanks. Yes. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen again. What a marvelous word. Because all of us need a painkiller. Amen.
Amen.
But it's not a painkiller we think we need. Amen. Somebody say, what can wash away my sins? What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Amen. And we thank God that he sent somebody to kill our pain for us. No matter what kind of suffering you're going through. Amen.
Amen.
She can't kill your pain. Amen.
Amen.
She might make you think you ain't got no pain sometimes. Any pain, but she can't kill it. Amen. But Jesus can take the pain away. And we thank God for this man of God for reminding us. Amen. Of Beth and David. Did it not hear house burn as he spoke to us by the wayside? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. We thank God for Minister Allen for just letting God use him. Amen. Amen. To speak to us today. Amen. I heard it. I heard it in my spirit, man. And then what I heard real clear is that as men, amen, that's some stuff that we need to talk about. Amen.
Amen.
And let me say that again. That's some stuff that we need to talk about. Amen.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. A lot of men die because they ignore symptoms of things that's killing them. Amen. Won't go to the doctor. Because we say, well, I'm going to bear this pain. And then by the time we get to the doctor, whatever it is that's half killing us or whole killing us. Amen. Because we try to endure stuff he won't talk about. Amen. And then when our wives and girlfriends and significant others try to talk about, we try to shut them down. I won't talk about it. Well, somebody needs to talk about it. Yes. Amen. So I thank God for Minister Allen reminding us, and I know that that was a call for men to come together to be refocus on our men ministry. Amen. As we refocus on our men ministry. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we thank God for you. And I know we're going to be hearing more about the men ministry. Amen.
Amen.
And we'll hear more about the Tuesday Bible study, our men ministry. Amen. Also, we're going to, not this Tuesday, but the following Tuesday, we're going to be showing a movie here called Courageous. Amen. And it's a movie about things men need to do, but I want women to see it too. I want all of us to see it as a church family. So put that on your calendar. Not this Tuesday, but the following Tuesday, we're going to be showing the movie Courageous. Amen. And we're going to have it set up in the back, and we're going to have popcorn too. Amen. 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 And we're going to talk about some things. Amen. We're going to, because of the fall to Courageous, is a book called Resolution. Amen. So you're going to be hearing more about that. Marking your calendar this Friday, at beginning at 6:30. We're going to be having a service here at 6:30. Sansa's going to be speaking, and she talks to us about the things that's going on in Uganda. Amen. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, look for, I told you, Google Kony 2012, K-O-N-Y 2012, K-O-N-Y 2012. Some of you don't have to wait, get home. Amen. You can Google on your way out the door. Amen. 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 Let us all stand. Let us all stand.